four. He is the first option. And so, therefore, as good as he is, you're looking to get him the basketball, make sure he gets his tongue fixed. The 1-3-1 half court back into the zone. And again, Allen. Alston into the corner. Basket is good. And the foul on Bolden. Into the game for Georgia Tech.
Now you're always telling me about all these places. You got any idea where Shipman, Virginia is?
You probably have a better idea than I do.
Oh, I know where it is. I'm asking you. You're my geography guy.
International geography. Were actually considered at Georgia Tech. Academics were a big factor for him in his decision.
It surely was. Also considered Harvard. Tell me right now. Love watching her in the crowd. She brings the energy and the excitement regardless as to whether they're home or away.
Akogensen. What sort of growth is there for Duke on the defensive end?
The normal buy-in comes with experience. And that's the thing. These are guys, are young guys, getting a lot of minutes.
There is Carter, the freshman out of Atlanta. Off the side of the rim, Okogie pushing.
And that's where Josh Okogie has to be able to get a turnover. When these guys get into the paint, they need to be looking to score.
Bolden against Lammers. Kicks it back. Allen hit 10 points early.
Well, he's the key to Duke's success. He's the veteran. He's got him on the outside, and you see already 2 3-pointers made in this game.
He had been the only senior playing with 4 freshmen in that starting five.
The offensive end of the floor. Kogi's one of the best offensive players in the ACC, but he's been paid a lot of attention to finding Jackson in the corner. That one
had a sense of humor about it. Back, and there's no way around it. Alvarado's a huge loss.
And Alvarado actually had not been outed to not have the freshman point guard on the court. Todrick Jackson stepping back into the lineup, and they're going to have other players stepping up in the absence of Alvarado. Now we see Gary Trent Jr. attacking the basket and finding his way to the rim.
Okogie,
can you tell me someone that UConn has not had their number? Josh Okogie getting back to the free throw line, where he leads the ACC in free throw attempts per game.
From three in ACC play.
And now made, that would be 36 out of his last 61 three-point talent around him. And what he's become is the shooter.
Was known as the Shaq of the Mac.
These guys going to the left-hand jump hook, really showing the development of those guys as players and what they've been able to accomplish. They weren't doing this in high school.
Okogie could not dribble through the D. Carter. That one win. Here is Okogie. Through traffic, denied. Lammers.
You know this from coaching against him. There's always a point, in normally in February, where Coach K makes us draft.
Okogie again. Three is not there, and Carter,
so you can live with him taking one of those. The problem is, this is where he's at his best, attacking the basket.
He's not a big-time recruit, but Okogie said he was sold on Georgia Tech when Josh Pastner told him, listen, we are going to play fast.
And Josh Okogie is the second.
Jerome Robinson
is number one. When you're dropping 46 and leading the ACC in scoring, and he has a chance to be a special player, although I'm sure this is the only year we will see him in college basketball.
Okogie on the
up, laying it in. They say, and this is what they say, the shoot. He wanted to make sure he was part of a high academic institution.
Final
C, if there was one team that I thought could finish up undefeated, 6-0 for the remainder of the season, and my answer to that question was Duke. And the reason being is because I honestly feel that the losses that they've taken, I think, ever, not the best.
Okay, who's the best?
My favorite, probably my favorite college player.
And this is fact.
This is fact. 20.6 points per game, 8.1 assists per game, and not only national champion, UNLV. So, you know, that's a lot to be said. Jabari Parker at the 5, Rodney Hood at the 4. They go on to be successful. So, again, it's always a drastic change at some point during the year that allows Duke success with Coach K pulling the strong.
Month away from Selection Sunday.
That's going to be interesting to see. A lot of it has to do with the fact that Bagley's not in the game. But I don't think that Duke can survive. as well. And, you know, we talk about that Michigan State game where Grayson went for 37. DeVal had 17 points and 10 assists in that game. And now we see him attack the basket.
A heart attack less than 2 weeks ago. DeVal. His current research project involves working with ultrasound machines where they look at structures and they can find out if that structure is crumbling. And he says down the road,
a player. Absolutely. And a very good basketball player. Just seeing another one of those. So Ben Lambert's going to have to take on a much larger role in the offense and getting his teammates involved and getting the shots. Defensive energy up. Goldwire now getting an opportunity to get in and get in the mix. And he's a guy I think that could help them, especially on the defensive end as well. He's played and getting his confidence back, getting out of that slump.
Kogi will pull up three, rebound. Kogi off the Lammer screen.
In 75% of the games, but he will be at the top of the list in many of those, especially free throw attempts per game. When you look at it, once he gets to a point to where he gets to 75% of game played, Kogi won that mix. You know, and when you look at Duke traditionally, Coach K.
Kogi. With a 16-point lead.
And Georgia Tech fans not happy about that.
DeVal, his third. 1-1 for Kogi.
Because of the energy that Georgia Tech has brought into the building.
DeVal down the lane, off the window. Tapped by Bolden. Here comes Georgia Tech. Kogi out in front. Kogi in the team.
The most talented teams in the country.
Kogi over Carter. Moses right on the glass and able to draw. Lammers turns, shoots. Deloria the rebound.
And the right guy in the right spot. Ben Lammers is the guy that Josh Pastner wants in the middle of the zone.
Single bonus.
And Kogi just trying to pick up on the ball there.
DeVal, 61% free throw shooter. This is the front end.
And that was created by Josh Okogie, just getting in there, mixing it up.
Jackson, no.